topic today. Okay, references. A reference describes one source of information. So a reference is one source of information, and references would be put usually at the end of our documentation. It will show a list of information sources. Usually it would be described using the chosen referencing style or format. We will talk about the referencing style later. The purpose of references is first to avoid plagiarism, and then to identify the context of the research, and then to give support and validation, and the last one to identify the sources. Okay, first, we need to avoid plagiarism, since integration from intellectual morality is something that we should achieve in our science community. So we must ensure that the credibility, our credibility of our publication that there is credibility in our publication by avoiding any attempt to do some manipulation, fabrication, or falsify our data and do some plagiarism. So plagiarism is just one part of the story, because there are some data manipulation or data fabrication. We have learned about data fabrication recently from one professor that quite a famous one. And we just found out that there are some data fabrication, and there are many examples of publication that make people believe on something that actually not happened because of the data fabrication. One of them is about the dangers of MSG. It started from a scientific article, but then we found out that everything is fabricated. The other one is that there is some vaccination that lead to autism. It's very famous last time. And that belief, even most of the people in health department believe on that because there are a scientific article regarding that matter. However, last time we have found out that everything is fabricated. So there are many ways to do something bad and misleading people with our research. So we must avoid that. One of them is plagiarism. So plagiarism is the act of taking credit from other people's work or ideas. By doing in plagiarism, first you steal something from other people, and then the second one, you lie that this is yours. So you commit to crime, actually, because everything, even from ideas, word, diagrams, picture, or anything, if you present it on your research, you have to acknowledge the other people. So you have to reference them. If you didn't reference anything, it would be considered as your own work. You cannot state that I forget to put some referencing on this. You forgot means you steal it. I forgot to pay. You cannot say something like that when you take something from example from the supermarket and then go out. And then when the police catch you, and then you say, I forgot to pay, please. Or if you like do something wrong and then you say, just simply say, I forgot. You cannot do that. And it's the same with plagiarism. When you didn't mention the reference, that means you are guilty. Usually we can check your paper using Turnitin. We will talk about this before our last presentation. I think it's around 14 weeks. I will give you a link to check your paper to avoid the plagiarism. Okay, the second one is to identify context to ensure that we are talking in the same area. To place your work in the context with other recognized publications. So this is just to show the others that we are talking about the same thing. And then it would show the strength of the work. And then show that actually I do some extension from the thing that already recognized by the other people. And then to show how the work resides within a recognized academic field. This is like the domain of research, but more detail on that. So if you are talking about pattern recognition, which kind of pattern, which kind of method, which kind of algorithm, that is the academic field of study. And then the third one, why we need to do the references, is to support ourselves, to support our own arguments, because we cannot argue and we cannot claim something using our own feeling. Why do you do this? Because I think that is the wrong answer of the question. When you try to claim or to make some point, you have to back it up with some references. You have to show that this is not the thing that I just thought, but this is the thing that everyone has already researched about this. There is some data to support my claim. There is other research that already found about this. So to support our own arguments, we need to have some references. And then to identify sources, that means to give the reader a comprehensive list of related work to help them understand our research. By identifying sources clearly, the reader will be able to look at the used articles in our research. So the format that we use here in Ubaya is APA, but however, there are many kind of referencing style. There are MLE, usually this is for the writer. CTGO and then Harvard, IEEE, ACM, and there are many other different style, but here, if you create a thesis or kerja praktek in Ubaya, you need to use APA referencing style. Even that APA is abbreviation for American Psychological Association, however, this is a common style in engineering publication. We have talked about references, in general. Now about the citation. Citation is the use of a reference on the text. If you have references list, you only like put the detail of the literature. A citation is the thing that you took out from the book. So for example, if you found an interesting paragraph, you can cite that paragraph in your work. So inside the text of your documentation or report, that is called citation. The purpose of citation to show the difference and the extension, if any, of your work from the other people's works, or to back up your claim. Now, so how you do the citation? The first one is to write the in-text citation. In each first cited sentence. So for example, if you have 5 sentences in a paragraph, the first sentence and the second sentences and the third and the fourth came from a book, you have to put the citation on the first sentence, not the second and not the last one. Because when people read that and found the sign of the citation in your first sentence, he will assume that the second, the third, and the fourth would came from the same reference. If you put it on the last, people will never know when the reference started. If you put it on the first sentence, then they can assume that the second and the third is the same until they found another citation. That means, okay, change literature, change book. But if you put it on the last, people will never know when is the starting point you take from the book. That's why you have to put it on the first sentence. And then you have to put everything that you cite on the reference list. And this is just in the reference list, title must be started with capital alphabet and in italic. Okay, there are 2 types of citation. The first one we call paraphrase, and the second one is direct quotation. We will talk about this one at a time. Okay, the first one, paraphrase. Paraphrase means that you will learn about this, we will talk about this in our own language. So if you read something and then try to describe the idea with your own words, that is paraphrase. So in paraphrase, it is very important that you still have to refer, even if you use your own words. The idea behind that is not your own. That's why you still have to acknowledge the one who previously talked about that. One of the things that can be called as a plagiarism is that I do the paraphrasing, but I never mentioned that this idea came from another book, because that students think that, but I write it down by myself. I didn't do the copy and paste. Yes, you didn't do the copy and paste. However, you read it and you understand it, and then you talk the same idea with that book. It's still not yours, even though you are using your own words. And then paraphrase required in all parts of the literature review. So basically, like almost all of the second chapter, the literature review in your thesis, you have to do the paraphrasing on in overall of that. You are not allowed to copy and paste even when you are mentioning the original writer. Even if you are talking that I take this from that book, you cannot do the copy and paste. If you fail to paraphrase, we can say that this is plagiarism. And this is like the most common failure in the story of this subject. So most of, if you heard about this subject, and maybe some people say that not many people pass this subject, it's because of two things usually. The first one, because they are not submitting their work. Because they didn't do the consultation properly and haven't finished their works and not submitting it. The second one, because they are not paraphrasing, and just because maybe there are not many time left, so to make it simple, they just copy and paste, hope that maybe he didn't get caught, but we are using Turnitin, so I think it's very easy to recognize any kind of plagiarism. To do the paraphrasing, at first, you need to understand the whole content of the literature. You need to understand it first before you can state it again with your own language, with your own words. If you are not understanding, it seems like if you want to teach to someone, when you write down your thesis, it seems like you are teaching somebody else about the thing that you have done. So it's like a teacher. If the teacher didn't understand everything, he cannot teach. If I don't understand about this, I cannot teach this subject. So I can only teach the thing that I already understand. If I don't understand the subject, maybe I will just only read everything that every word in my presentation. Maybe the presentation created by other people, and then I just read it down. It seems like copy and paste, right? But if I understand about this, I can speak like this. I can speak without like use the same word with the thing that placed in the presentation. That's the same with paraphrase. You can only do the paraphrase if you understand it. Okay, so the first thing is to understand it, and then you can choose some parts that relevant with your thesis. That parts would be the part that would be cited. And then after you choose it, try to write down the main themes to be elaborated. So you create some structure. I will talk about this first, and then the second, I will talk about the other thing. So you create the structure of your explanation on your documentation, the basic idea, and so on. And then you try to find the literature that can help to back up your structure. And then I suggest you, especially if your literature is in Bahasa Indonesia, I suggest you to just close the literature. If you understand it, you're supposed to, I think you can write it down without reading it. It's like something like this. If you understand one topic, you can explain it to other people without reading anything while you explaining. after you watch a movie and then you understand the story behind that, sorry, not the story behind, the whole story of the movie, you can tell the story to other people without you have to take a look at the movie for a couple of minutes and then talk about it for a couple of minutes as well. So you don't have to pick on the resource if you really understand it. That's why you have to understand it before you write the paraphrasing. Why we need to close the literature? To make a good writing. Because otherwise, you will really heavily copying the literature. Sometimes you are not aware that actually you do the copy and paste, not digitally, but manually. Like you read it and then you type the same thing, the same word, because it feels like you cannot find any other word. It would block your mind. So I think it would be better for you if you close the literature, but if you forget about everything, it's okay. You can open it again, read it again, over and over again, and then close it. After you close it, start to type your own paraphrasing. It would be help if you can choose the main and important words that describe the phrase. You can use the same word, but it would be better if you can find another word but have the same meaning with it. Okay. You can use the same keyword. However, it would be better if you use it as little as you can. So there are some words that have a strong meaning, such as if I'm talking about a mobile application, I think it would be better because it's a jargon. So it would be difficult to change that word. However, there are some other words that can be changed and still have the same vibe and meaning. And then it would be better if you document the location of the cited phrase. Otherwise, you would feel very difficult to track down the paraphrasing, especially when your lecturer maybe asks you to delete that part, or maybe ask you to take more on that part. If you didn't keep the location on the literature, it would be very difficult for you because you need to read all the literature again to find where is this come from. And then you need to recheck if your paraphrasing have the same idea with the one inside the literature. You can check it with other people when they read about it and read your paraphrasing. Are you have the same idea about this? Okay, is there any question? You can ask any question in the middle of my explanation. You don't have to wait.
Excuse me, ma'am. I want to ask something. You said before Upaya using APA, but how about if we write our proposal without APA? Is that acceptable or it's still we should use okay. ABA.
Because your proposal sometimes not using any references, so it's still all right if you are not using any kind of references because you haven't know about this before. But if you have some referencing in the proposal, started from now, just swap it into APA style. Usually we are using references for the thesis, so I think it's all right for the proposal.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, I will continue. Okay, the tips to do the paraphrase is first, you need to change the word. Sometimes I use thesaurus. If you open, I would stop sharing first. Wait. Okay, if you open anything such as Microsoft Word. Okay, I try to open my Word. However, usually this one is in English. But I think there are some thesaurus in Indonesia as well. Okay, so this is my Microsoft Word. If I write down about example, I can try to find another word by pressing the Shift F7. If you press the Shift F7, then they will give you some alternative for the word example. You can use specimen, case, illustration, and then model, pattern, whatever. Try to find the most close meaning words. So you really need to understand each of the word, not just speak randomly. So for example, you need to take a look at the context. This is just one word, but maybe if you have a sentence and then you feel like this sentence have too many words that are exactly the same with my previous source. So you think maybe you need to change some of the words, you can use thesaurus. Okay.
Literature. Literature. Literature.
Okay, the second way to do the paraphrasing is change the structure from active to passive. Even though usually in research documentation or research article, we often use a passive tone. So rather than using an active tone, usually we are using a passive tone, even in Indonesian. So for example, rather than talk about memiliki, we use dimiliki. Okay. So that's why you might found many passive sentences in an article. We use more passive sentences usually to avoid using the first, I cannot find the term in English, so I use bahasa Indonesia, kata ganti orang pertama, such as kita, saya, penulis. We cannot use all of that in our article. So to avoid using that, sometimes we can use a passive sentences. Okay, and then we can change the active and passive. We can combine material from different sources. So for example, there are two literature, the book and another article maybe, talk about the same thing. We can combine both into one new sentence. It would help us to do the paraphrasing. Okay, so we will take a look at the rule of in-text citation. Inside the in-text citation, we have to give a bracket and then put the author's last name and the year of publication. If the author's name already included inside the sentence, you only need to put the year inside the bracket. For example, like this. This is the paraphrasing of a sentence from the book of Grazer that created on 2011. Grazer is the author's last name. Never put the full name or the first name. You need to pick the last name. Okay, and then the second example is this one. Because the sentence is like this. Guess and Veronese found that the most important element in comprehending non-native speech is familiarity with the topic. That's the whole sentence. Because the whole sentence includes the author's last name already, so we don't have to put the guess and Veronese inside the bracket. Just put 1984. In the first sentence, you didn't put Grazer inside the sentence because the sentence is just explained. Role play can help children learn techniques for copying with bullying. It isn't stated something like, Grazer once mentioned that role play can help blah, blah, blah. If you put the sentence like that, you don't have to put Grazer again inside this bracket. But if you never mention Grazer inside your sentence, you would have to put the author's last name in the bracket. Which one is better? You can use this in different moments. So it's just try to make your writing as good as you can. That means if the reader read the article, they can feel the flowing of the explanation. Just put it like that. So we can use both of them in different occasions. And then if there are group author like this one, at the first appearance, For example, if this is an association like ACM or APA, and the first appearance, you have to put the whole name, but then you can use the abbreviation on the next appearance, like this one. If there are more than one author, just like Getz and Ferenc previously, you can put this sign. If there are two authors, if there are 3 to 5, you can use the sign. However, this is just for the first appearance. For the next one, you can use at all. At all means like with friends, with their colleagues. However, if there are 6 or more, you need to use at all started from the beginning, otherwise it would be too long. Okay, this is for the multiple author. If you create a sentence from 2 other articles, from 2 different articles, from 2 different resources, 2 or 3 or 4 or 5, you can put all the resources inside the bracket as well. That this is the example. That means this sentence took the idea from Getz and Ferenc and from Gretz Thomas. Okay, wait. I think this is, there are some mistakes here. Because you only need to write down the last name. The last name would be Thomas. Okay, I see it. Okay, please change this one. So we cannot write Krenz Thomas. It's just Thomas because you only need to put the last name. Okay, if there are some incomplete detail on the name and the year that you need to put in the bracket, that's all right. You can use the title if you cannot find the author name. If you cannot find the year, you can use ND, no date, like this one. So you cannot find the date of the article. And this one, you cannot find the owner or the writer of this article. It's just stated that this is the article from what, if you can find the organization, you can put the organization here. If you cannot find anything, you can put the title. Okay. Now, I talk about direct quote after I talk about paraphrasing because this is not recommended. This is just, if you really, really need to do this, that means there is no way to paraphrase it. This is the only copy and paste allowed inside a research article, and you only can do this like once. Or maximum 2. And usually it's just for something that you really worried if I paraphrase it and it will be misleading for everyone. So if you can paraphrase it, usually we will ask you to change it to paraphrasing. We don't like to read about the direct quotation like this. This is the example of direct quotation. There is a sign like this in the direct quotation, if you can see. You still have to put the last names. You need to put it inside indented block. So you don't have to give that sign, but you need to put it in. You have to create an indented block to show that. There are some pages as well here. Please erase that. Okay, we don't need the bits, okay? Wait, that's about the direct quotation. So there are two ways to do the citation. The first one is the paraphrasing. That means you change everything using your own words. The second one is the direct quotation. That means you copy and paste it, but do that like once for the whole book. And if you really, really need to, I never do any kind of direct quotation while I'm reading many of my articles. So actually it's just something that placed there because we cannot do anything else about it. Okay, now about the reference list. Reference list usually put at the end of our documentation. Show the list of sources of everything that we have been cited before. Okay, so the first one usually came from a journal, article from a journal or proceeding. Usually it would be like this. The first one is the author. You put the last name, and then for the other name, you only need to abbreviate it into alphabet. So for example, for my name, how would you put it inside this? What is my name? You know my full name? Okay, anyone here know my full name?
I don't know. As far as I know, your full name in daftar pustaka will be written as Angga M.
Okay. Actually, my full name is Ang Melisa Angga. That means Angga, and then. MM. So if, for example, like this one, Alexander, I try to find the three words name. Suddenly I lost it. Alexander Abdiwijaya Sutiono. How would you put your name on the outer?
Alexander.
No.
AS.
No, which name that you have to put on the front part?
Clan name, maybe, ma'am?
Yes.
Marga.
Alexander Abdiwijaya Sutiono. I used that name, Alexander Abdiwijaya Sutiono. What is the last name of Alexander Abdiwijaya Sutiono?
Sutiono.
Sutiono. So you have to write it like Sutiono and then?
Sutiono Alexander Abdiwijaya.
No, you need to abbreviate it. You have to use only the first character of the other name. Like this one. So it would be Sutiono.
A. A.
A. And then there's
A again.
Yes. So it would be Sutiono A. A.
Oh.
Okay. Next, Christian Putra Landomalo.
Yes, ma'am.
How would you put your name in this? We already give the example before, right? What is your last name?
Journal, ma'am.
Excuse me? Christian Putra Landomalo, which one is the last name?
Landomalo, ma'am. Lando.
You only use one name. Landomalo is like two words, so it should be Malo, right?
Can Lando, ma'am.
Lando.
Yes, my last name is Lando, ma'am.
Okay, but how can you put the Malo after Lando? It would be confusing, so I think I have to use Malo.
Oh, Lando is my marga, ma'am.
What about Malo? What is
Malo? Malo is my marga.
Is it supposed to be one word? Lando Malo, is it supposed to be one word?
Lando Malo is my Lando is marga my father and my mother, and Malo marga is my father.
Okay, you only can put a one word, and it has to be the last word, Christian. So it should be Malo then. Okay, so I have to put Malo, and then what is after Malo, what should we put in the name? There are three other words, right? That would be, the other can help, please. Malo, and then
KPL.
Malo KP.
Malo.
Malo
KPL.
KPL. Malo KP. Malo KPL. Okay. What about okay, I don't know if this is your name only have one name, Hans. Is there only one name? One word on your name? Hans?
Hans Christian, ma'am.
Oh, it should be Hans Christian. Is there anyone here that only have one name? Okay, maybe just use Mr. Jimmy. You know, Mr. Jimmy only have one name. What happen if there is only one name? How would we write it?
I think we write it as is, ma'am.
So just Jimmy and stop.
And maybe if he has a title.
No, we're not using any kind of title here.
Oh, okay, okay. Okay, yeah,
we cannot put, for example, master of something. We cannot put it here. Just the name.
Oh, I see, I see. Okay, I think should put the name as is.
So it would be Jimmy and then 1990?
Yes.
Okay, so there are two ways to do this. The first one, just put Jimmy and then 1990, but sometimes the editor would turn it back to us and say that you do something wrong. There's something wrong with your reference list and you have to change it. That means usually if we only have one name, usually we put the first name and the last name as the same name. So for Jimmy, it would be Jimmy Jimmy. The other example is like Miss Lisana. It would be Lisana Lisana. So all of my friends that have one name usually would be called, the first name and the last name would be the same name. So it would be Jimmy and then J. That's the example if you only have one name. Okay, the second part is the year. Put it inside the bracket. Always give a stop after, for example, after the author like this one. And then another stop after the publication year. And then after the article title, stop it again. And so on. Okay, after the publication year, there would be the article title. You don't have to use the italic here. The italic would be in the title of the journal. So the title of the journal would be created in italic, including the volume and issue. And then put the bits that you use here. This one means this is from page 147 to 148. The volume is 13, the issue is 3 to 4. Okay, this is the journal, and actually almost everything is similar like this one. You can take a look at, this is the online journal. You just put another information, that is the DOI or retrieved from which journal. DOI is the number to show, it's like a digital number for articles. So this is the DOI, but if you don't have the number of the articles, you can change it to URL. You can put the word retrieved from and then put the URL. Otherwise, you can put DOI and then put the number. Okay. This is for the book. The difference between the previous one, because this is book, so there's only one title. That is the title of the book. That's why the italic part is the title of the book. And then we have the publisher city and state. And then the name of the publisher itself. This is for the ebook. So everything with E there, you can put the retrieve from or DOI. Because there are no publication, so you don't have to put the publication there. two of the first part, it's always like the author and the year of publication. So this is how we recognize if we are interested with everything that we read in your citation previously. Usually we will open the reference list and then try to find the book by ourselves. Okay, a book chapter is like, actually it's a book which consists of some research from many people. So one researcher would be given one chapter inside the book. So that's why the author here is the chapter author's last name. It's the chapter author, not the author of the book. Because the important part is the chapter inside the book. It's different with the ordinary book. And then the year published, like usually. And this is like the journal because there are book title and then there would be chapter title. So just like the journal, the title of the article is not in italic. The title of the book is in italic. You have to put the word in last name of editor and then put the word X. If there are more than one editors like this one, you have to put both. And this time, you put the last name at the end. Usually the last name is at the beginning because this is like a sentence in S.R. Binford and R.R. Binford book. If we read it, it's like something like that. And then you can put the keyword retrieved from or the DOI. If this is online, if this is offline, you need to put the publisher. Just like the one in the book. Okay, this is the book chapter. This is the web article, if there is any. Remember, if you have something from the web, you have to ensure that the author is competent. This is a researcher or scientist. Otherwise, it would be not valid as a literature. This is if you cannot find the author, maybe from the organization, from the YouTube video. I put all of this at the end part because we only use this if we cannot find anything from journal and everything. So we suggest you not to use this if you don't have to. The web, the YouTube video, and then the last one is the personal interview, because especially this one, because there is no evidence that you really do this. The one that know that you really do this, only you and the one that you interview. You have to put the keyword personal interview if you use something like this. Okay. And this one is the online lecture. We suggest not to use this only if you have to. Maybe you never found or you already tried to find, but you cannot find anything. You only found it from your lecturer, online lecture. this is the encyclopedia. You cannot use this as well, only if you have to. Okay, so there are some common mistakes that that would be found usually in the literature review. The first one is forget to put in text citation. So you actually you already paraphrase everything, but you never put the bracket that show that this is came from another article. You never mention the name and the year of publication. This is very dangerous because if there is no sign of citation and referencing, that means you claim that everything is your own. So we can accuse you of plagiarism because of this. Okay, the second common mistake is actually this is not a mistake maybe, but if we read something like this, it feels strange, and usually we will ask you to change the way you are writing. The second one is strange or incomplete sentence because you do the citation. This is the example. I use Bahasa Indonesia here. Okay, something like this. Remember that the citation is put inside the bracket. That means a bracket should be able to be erased. When you erase this one, it would be something like this. Okay, if you erase the bracket, it would be something like this. So if you read something like this, it is strange, right? This is an incomplete sentence. Menyatakan bahwa, who menyatakan bahwa? You have to put something in front of the menyatakan word. Otherwise, it would felt strange. So if you put any citation, remember that everything inside the bracket can be erased. So just read it without the bracket. And how do you feel? Is it strange or incomplete or not? There are many ways to fix it. You don't have to use the name inside the sentence. You can do that like this one in a passive tone. I use the word ditemukan as a passive verb. Berdasarkan penelitian bla bla bla, ditemukan bahwa bla bla bla, without mentioning the word dandi. And then I put 2020 inside the bracket. The second one, I put the word Dandi in front of the menyatakan bahwa. Dandi menyatakan bahwa, if I erase the bracket is only state 2020. If I erase the bracket, the 2020 part, it would be Dandi menyatakan bahwa. So it's not strange. Or you can put the word Dandi inside the sentence like this one. Berdasarkan penelitian yang telah dilakukan Dandi, blah, 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 ditemukan bahwa, so there are many ways to write down about this. Okay, another common mistake. This is not mistakes again, but this is strings. So usually we ask you to change it as well. Is that you are using the same style for every sentence. So when you read it, it's like a repetition of something. Dandi menyatakan bahwa, and then Robert menyatakan bahwa, and then Sentosa menyatakan bahwa. Every word started with the key words. The author's name, and then menyatakan bahwa. When you read overall, it felt strange and not flowing enough. So you have to change it. And then this is a dangerous mistakes because you can accuse as plagiarized. The paraphrasing almost identical in structure and the use of words with the original one. So sometimes this is called plagiarism as well. Even though you have some different words, but most of the words are exactly the same. Some lecturers just put this as a plagiarism, and some reviewer put this as plagiarism as well. Okay, is there any question about this?
Ma'am, can I see more examples of paraphrasing, please?
Okay, I think I would better open the discussion, but you already submit some literature review, right? Before you know about the paraphrasing stuff.
Yes.
Check it again and try to paraphrase it. And then we will talk about that later. Would you like to do that inside a breakout room? Like the previous one? Or do that by yourself?
Ma'am, previously during my first version of my proposal, I have input some reference, at least one reference, but then when I give it to my dosbing, he said that my background is too long, and so when I check again, I think that the references is not quite important, so I delete it from my proposal.
It's okay, just use it because we are in discussion here. So it's all right if you are not really use it inside the proposal. You might can use it inside your thesis, right?
Okay. Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So I think I would put you inside the breakout rooms like previously. Okay. I try to remember the name of the domain, topic domain. I have game development, system informasi. Is there anything that you would like to add? Okay, video dan animasi.
Excuse me, ma'am. I want to ask my friend before I just two people in the group 9 and he does not here right now.
Okay. What is your topic about?
Computer vision.
Is there anyone from the DSAI program? Okay, I just put under topic here, okay? If you can not found one that's suitable for you, you can just choose the other topic. Okay, I already open all rooms. Please feel free to join the breakout room and discuss what I mean discuss here is just you can show each other your works and then try to be the reviewer for each other. Okay, we will talk about this after like 20 minutes. I think it's enough. Okay, see you there.
Halo Chris. Ini suara apa ya tadi? Aku nggak dengerin deh. Konsentrasi datar belakang. Oh alah. Kayak minggu kemarin itu ya. Salah satu harus ada yang nge-open terus minta pendapatnya satu sama lain gitu. Jasmine.
Oh, belum aku. Mungkin dari yang lain yang udah fix bisa memberikan gambaran.
Halo. Ini gimana kita? Disuruh apa sih? Oh, proposal kita ya. Coba ada yang mau di-share screen punyanya? Maksudnya itu parafrasi itu maksudnya yang setahu aku tuh parafrasi kan kayak kamu lihat dia dari jurnal-jurnal yang mana gitu contoh proposalnya terus kayak satu kalimat sampai titik gitu kamu parafrasikan jangan jangan tulis sesuai seperti itu jadi parafrasi sesuai kayak
jadi parafrase itu kalian membaca satu sebuah kalimat terus dipahami intinya, kemudian diketik dengan bahasa kalian masing-masing. Gitu.
Sebenarnya kalau peraturan daerah harus sama. Ya, kalau peraturan daerah emang nggak perlu diubah. Langsung di copy paste aja. Ya.
Yeah. Oh, berarti kalau misalkan dari jurnal lain atau kutipan contohnya kayak gitu itu dijelaskan lagi menurut pemahaman kita gitu.
Iya. Yeah.
Kalau dari jurnal lain baru pakai kata-kata sendiri. Soalnya kan nanti kalau sama persis tuh kenanya plagiarisme.
Halo, aku boleh share screen enggak? Mau nanya aku.
Yuk, silakan.
Oke, aku share screen yo. Kelihatan belum? Oke, aku nanya ini. Aku kan citasi ini ambil 4 ya daftar pustaka. Ini tuh dari buku, ini dari BPS. Nah ini dua ini dari website ini. Tapi dari yang ini redaksi bisnis UKM ini judulnya kayak gini. Ini kira-kira bisa nggak dijadikan citasi? Cuma tulisannya ini sih, redaksi bisnis UKM doang. Oh.
Bisa website harusnya. Saya ingat. Ini berita sih, website berita. Soalnya berita kan paling biasa.
Oleh redaksi UKM. Terus ini juga, ini nggak ada nama penulisnya sih. U apa tulis di sita?
Ini. Nah, kalau nggak ada jurnalisnya ini rada susah kalau dijelasin. Valid apa enggak? Sumbernya jadi ambigu kan?
Ah iya yes. Ya. Gimana Chris? Saya aku lupa ya. Saat berapa itu? Oh, ada stylenya yuk. Citasi itu. Oh, ini MLA, APA, Cicago.
Pakai APA.
APA. Ini sih, Astamir. Merah dulu mas.
Ini sih, dari website, sesuai slide lo ya. Itu, le nggak ada penulis sih. Langsung judul itu aja. Judul, tahun, bulan, asli itu URL ya.
Judul, tahun, bulan, sih. Tahun sih berarti tak balik ya ini.
Citasi iya pakai APA.
Kok apa?
Selama kalau citasi web, jangan lupa informasi kapan dilihatnya itu. Misalnya ngambilnya tuh hari ini.
Oh, nambahnya di apa proposal gitu kah?
Iya.
Oke. Okay. Di merah ini. Oke, itu aja sih. Thank you ya. Mungkin ada lagi yang mau pengen share gitu, mau nanya-nanya. Soalnya aku lihat beberapa yang lain nggak ada daftar pustaka ya. Citasinya ya cuman kayak di latar belakang, kutipan, nama, dan lain-lain. Jadi nggak ada daftar pustaka. Untuk proposal ya. Ya, Bu Mel aja. Oi Chris, halo. Pakai tool ta? Oh. Ini aku kok buka terus presentation kok masih nggak ada ya?
Kalau otomatis biasanya ya pakai Mendeley juga bisa. Ya.
Oh, harus ngisi itu dulu ta? Baru ke baru ke generate gitu. Oke, guys. Mantap.
Aku mau tanya share screen boleh tadi?
Boleh, enggak boleh.
Oke, aku share screen-nya. Bentar. Nah. Misalkan aku kan nemuin ya. Aku mau tanya apa nyari tentang sistem informasi produksi adalah apa kan. Nah, ini kan miliknya jurnal ilmiahnya ini kan anak Ubaya Bambang Sutejo. Itu di sini kan enggak ada tulisan, berarti aku nanti waktu sitasi pakai namanya Bambang Sutejo gitu dah. Waktu disitasinya. Waktu aku pakai di sininya di laporanku gitu. Gimana? Soalnya kan aku juga baca di sini daftar pustakanya juga enggak ada sistem informasi produksi. Makanya aku bingung. Jadi itu ambil dari sini juga, tadi pakai ini gitu citasinya nanti. Atau gimana?
Iya, harus.
Enggak apa berarti gitu ya.
Harus. Tapi cari jalan keluar lain, kamu cari ini yang lain deh, jurnal lain.
Oh, cari amannya gitu ya.
Cari amannya.
Oh, iya. Sering sih gitu itu, aku mesti nemu kayak ada gitu, cuman enggak ada siapa, menurut siapa gitu itu. Makanya aku ragu gitu apakah pakai gini itu benar apa enggak gitu. Oh, ya udah kalau gitu. Udah sih, itu aja menurut. Makasih ya.
Sama.
Oke, sudah kembali semua ya. Oke, ada yang mau share hasil paraphrase-nya? Yang di-share paraphrase-nya, lalu kemudian daftar pustakanya ya.
Bu, saya mau nanya sedikit, boleh?
Iya.
Gini, saya untuk proposalnya emang harus ditaruh daftar pustaka ya, Bu? Soalnya saya lihat beberapa contoh proposal itu nggak pakai daftar pustaka.
Bukannya harus, tetapi kan banyak yang minta ini kan, banyak yang minta bukti ya. Untuk latar belakang itu loh, kan seringkali kita ngomong banyak anak begini begitu, itu kan nggak ada buktinya. Nah, buktinya biasanya kan kita ngutip dari sumber lain.
Ya.
Sehingga kalau kita ngutip dari sumber lain itu, lebih baik diberi daftar pustaka di belakang, supaya yang baca, reviewer, atau dosennya itu bisa yakin bahwa ini beneran... beneran ada apa ya, ada penguatnya gitu ya, klaim tersebut.
Nah, terus kalau yang misalkan kayak yang udah disetujuin sama dosen pembimbing tuh, terus sudah dia udah kumpulkan tapi dia tidak memiliki daftar pustaka, itu gimana, Bu? Jadi kutipan ada tetap di latar belakangnya kayak kutipan citasinya gitu, cuman tidak memakai daftar pustaka, halaman daftar pustaka.
Ya, ditambah aja. Diri aku.
Oh. Terima kasih, Bu.
Oke, silakan. Paraphrase-nya bahasa Indonesia kan ya?
Iya.
Ya. Oke, silakan yang mau menunjukkan hasil paraphrase-nya.
Bu, masih mau tanya, Bu.
Okay.
Ini punya saya kan yang latar belakang itu hasil wawancara sendiri ya, Bu, ya, dari sumbernya. Nah, itu kan masuk citasi juga kan, Bu?
Enggak. Kalau wawancara enggak.
Oh, enggak. Bu.
Paraphrase itu dari literatur, dari tulisan lain.
Ya, Bu, makasih, Bu. Soalnya saya latar belakangnya ngambil langsung dari narasumbernya gitu, langsung tanya gitu.
Ya.
Berarti kalau cuma satu ya satu aja ya, Bu, ditulisnya. Nggak usah memaksakan.
Ya. Cuma satu ya satu. Jadi gimana? Silakan share screen atau apapun yang mau paraphrase. Tidak harus panjang.
Belum, Bu, baru mau buat daftar pustaka.
Duh, tadi kan masuk ke breakout room 20 menit itu.
Iya, saya kan baru masuk. Saya makanya bingung. Soalnya beberapa contoh kan nggak pakai daftar pustaka. Terus ada beberapa yang presentasi itu pakai daftar pustaka. Makanya saya... kesini nanya Ibu, kalau misalkan emang pakai daftar pustaka, saya tambahkan dulu ke halaman daftar pustaka baru.
Oh, tadi kamu nggak nanya ke teman-teman yang di grup breakout?
Sudah, cuman mereka juga masih ragu, Bu. Soalnya kan saya ngeliat beberapa...
Yang dikumpulkan tugas kemarin itu kan pasti ada paraphrase-nya kan pakai citation manager kan kemarin.
Iya, tapi...
pakai Mendeley kan?
Tapi nggak... ini, Bu, saya nggak bikin dari daftar pustaka. Saya kira cuman ya kutipan gitu doang.
Oh iya, ya terserah sih. Ya ada ngambil dari itu aja. Kan itu tadi tugasnya disuruh apa yang dikumpulkan itu diperbaiki.
Oh.
Oke, selain Rifki, yang lain tolong.
satu. Kalau saya boleh mencoba.
Ini berarti untuk sitasi sama referensi ini cuma ini tuh, Bu. Tambahan gitu aja. Ya, atau berarti nggak wajib dipakai gitu.
Akan wajib di bab 2.
Jadi kalau misalnya
wajib di proposal.
Oh ya.
Kalau bab 2-nya wajib.
Jadi misalkan kalau nggak pakai referensi atau sitasi di proposalnya berarti nggak apa-apa.
Nggak apa. Cuma kadang-kadang banyak dosen tuh yang minta ini ya, kalau pas cerita teknologi minta ngambil dari sumber lain, nah itu berarti harus dikasih. Misalnya ya, misalnya cerita teknologi atau apa. Saya menunggu ya.
Permisi, Bu.
Ya, yang bertanya langsung aja, nggak usah ngomong saya ini bertanya. Jadi sebenarnya kalau peraturan itu saya lebih suka masuk lampiran. Tapi ada dosen yang, jadi terserah pembimbingnya sih sebenarnya. Tapi kalau itu saya menganggap itu kan banyak tuh. Banyak, terus peraturan tuh saya tidak terlalu suka kalau di paraphrase. Takut berubah. Ya, silakan. Banyak atau sedikit? Maksudnya peraturannya banyak enggak yang kamu pakai? Oh, tapi pengertian ya. Kalau cuma pengertian seharusnya nggak ngambil dari peraturan bisa. Maksudnya kalau bukan peraturannya kan itu cuma kayak menjelaskan reklame itu apa ya. Saya kira kalau cuma reklame itu apa di paraphrase bisa sih. Kalau peraturan itu yang saya agak khawatir. Nah, karena saya agak khawatir, sedangkan di direct kan nggak bisa banyak-banyak, biasanya saya lebih menyarankan masuk lampiran, sehingga nggak disitasi. Kalau banyak. Ya.
Permisi, Bu. Saya boleh mencoba?
Iya, silakan.
Saya izin share screen ya, Bu. Saya pakai notepad nggak apa-apa ya, Bu, ya?
Nggak apa.
Oke. Nah, ini yang tadi saya dan teman-teman saya tadi coba, apa namanya? Parafrase.
Kalau pakai notepad bisa dibesarin nggak?
Dibesarkan gimana ya, Bu, maksudnya?
Font-nya.
Oh, font-nya. Sebentar. Segini.
Iya.
Oke. Yang atas ini yang kalimat aslinya, yang bawah ini yang saya dan teman-teman saya tadi parafrase. Mencoba parafrase bersama.
Oke. Tolong yang lainnya perhatikan. Jadi begini. Yang kita bisa paraphrase dari tempat lain, itu adalah hasil pikirannya mereka sendiri ya. Yang kita boleh cite dari sumber lain, itu adalah hasil pemikirannya mereka sendiri. Nah, yang atas itu kalimat aslinya ya. Yang bawah kan paraphrase-mu kan?
Iya.
kalau dari kalimat aslinya itu ada tahunnya gitu ya. Oh. Itu kelihatannya
yang ini ya, Bu.
Iya.
Enggak, yang saya tanda petik ini yang kalimat aslinya. Yang ini saya nambahkan sendiri.
Oh, gitu.
Iya. Yang ini juga. Maaf, yang ini.
Oke, oke. Iya. Iya. Oke, oke. Enggak jadi komentar. Tapi enggak apa sih, saya akan mengingatkan ya. Jadi kalau kalian lihat ada sesuatu yang ada tahunnya, bagian itu jangan diparafrase ya. Kalau kalian baca sesuatu yang ada tahunnya, karena berarti dia sudah memparafrase. Kalau kamu parafrase sesuatu yang sudah diparafrase, itu enggak boleh ya. Jadi kamu hanya boleh parafrase dari yang orang itu idekan sendiri. Nah, kalau ini tadi boleh berarti ya.
Oke.
Okay. Oke, saya minta komentar dulu dari yang lain mengenai paraphrase-nya. Mungkin kita baca aja langsung semuanya ya. Dari waktu beberapa menit untuk membaca pelan-pelan. Yang bawah ini berarti ininya ya. Ya. Daftar pustakanya ya.
Iya, yang ini daftar pustakanya.
Oke. Oke, silakan komentar yang ada pendapat silakan disampaikan.
Bu, itu nggak tahu sih ini gimana, cuman bukannya kalau ini dimasukkan ke proposal, bukannya jarak waktunya dari tahun ini lebih dari 5 tahun ya, Bu? Kalau 2015.
Oh, iya.
Minimal berarti 2016 atau 2017.
Iya. Kalau dari sisi paraphrase-nya ada komentar?
Harusnya menurut saya sih harusnya udah benar.
Oke, yang lain.
Berarti yang pertama memang dua nah, Noda juga dan kawan-kawan dua kontes.
Suaranya agak ini kurang jelas Bung.
Untuk yang pertama ini Noda dan kawan-kawan 2019 itu nggak harusnya ditulis satu saja atau ya satu saja, mungkin ditulis dua kali.
Tadi aturannya gimana? Aturannya ditulis semua kalau pertama kali. Kalau di slide tadi kan ada kan yang 3 sampai 5 orang. Terus selain itu ini di ini sih, ini di kalimat. Jadi kalau di kalimat ya terserah yang nulis.
Oh iya.
Tapi kalau kamu nulisnya pakai dan apa dan rekannya, maka di dalam itu datanya kurang lengkap gitu ya. Maka di dalam kurungnya harus lengkap. Nah, supaya di dalam kurungnya nggak harus ditulis lagi, ya kamu tulisnya lengkap aja di kalimatnya. Oke, sekarang saya minta, ini kan ada tulisan asalnya, ya, sama ininya, sama hasil paraphrase-nya. Coba dihitung kata yang sama. Ada berapa? Yang kalimat pertama aja. Oke, Lukas ada berapa?
Kata yang sama ada 12.
12. Nah, kata digunakan sama berguna itu dianggap sama apa enggak oleh Lukas?
Arti dari katanya itu sama, cuman secara pasif dan aktif aja bedanya.
Ya, kalau mendorong dan pendorong.
Untuk mendorong dan apa, Bu, tadi?
Pendorong dan mendorong.
Untuk bisa mendorong ya? Dan mendorong, mendorong itu aksinya, pendorong itu pelakunya.
Jadi kamu tadi hitungnya nggak include itu ya?
Nggak.
Oke. 13 itu menurut kamu banyak atau sedikit?
13 menurut saya banyak sih, Bu.
12 ya.
Iya.
Oke, thank you. Nah, jadi kalau dihitung dari jumlah kata, kata yang dipakai ini masih terlalu banyak kalau ini. Nah, selain dari jumlah kata, coba yang lain. Ada mengamati sesuatu enggak? Bagaimana dengan urutan kata-katanya? Apa komentar kalian terhadap urutan kata-kata di kalimat yang pertama?
Strukturnya masih sama.
Masih mirip ya?
Iya.
Apa tadi waktu buat ini tuh anu apa sambil lihat aslinya, originalnya?
Iya.
Oke. Sekarang coba Coba kamu buka. Bentar, diberi waktu ya, beberapa menit ya, semua ya, satu kelas ya. Lihat kalimat yang pertama, dimengerti artinya, setelah itu buka notepad baru. Atau setelah itu stop share. Masing-masing tulis sendiri-sendiri. Kalau lupa namanya enggak apa. Namanya nanti aja diisi. Pokoknya ada noda. Itu kan salah satunya. Namanya dikira-kira sendiri enggak apa. Oke, bisa di stop share, Valerie.
Oke, baik. Bu.
Kamu juga ketik di blank note ya?
Oh, buat blank note.
Iya, buat note kosong. Yang lain kan nggak punya source ini kan?
Iya. Oke, baik. Saya stop share ya, Bu ya?
Iya. Nah, sekarang saya beri waktu 5 menit lah. Semua tulis apa yang tadi ditulis. Nanti saya cek. Oke, coba saya lihat atau ada yang mau share hasilnya.
Cuman kata-kata aja Bu, lupa lupa nama sama itunya tadi.
Ya nggak apa.
Saya coba share ya Bu.
Oke, thank you Rifki. Nanti kita kembali ke sini. Yang lainnya? Christian? Christian, ada? Devi, ada?
Oh, iya, Bu. Ini yang kalimat pertama aja kan, Bu? Yang kedua tadi lupa. Ini yang kalimat pertama aja.
Iya. Ya.
Bentar, Bu. Kalau saya sih seperti ini.
Oke, Corki.
Iya, Bu.
Iya, langsung siar aja.
Kalau saya seperti ini, Bu.
Oke, kita diskusi tiga itu dulu. Tolong tiga orang ini gimana ya supaya bisa jadi satu? Ditulis di chat mungkin ya? Kopas di chat. Lalu tolong ya yang share screen nanti kembali Valerie. Kalian di kopaskan yang dari chat itu ke notes-nya Valerie tadi. Sudah di copy, Valerie?
Ini saya share screen yang barusan ya, Bu?
Iya, ya, sama hasil copy-nya tadi sudah ya.
Oke. Yang punya blank note saya sama yang punyanya yang saya copy ya?
Iya.
Oke, sebentar ya.
Tambah satu lagi ya dari saya.
Sebentar.
Nah, jadi sebenarnya dalam paraphrase ini ya, apa, saya nggak bisa ngomong ini 100% benar atau gimana ya. Tetapi yang kita lihat itu adalah satu, jangan sampai masih mirip. Feel-nya itu kan kerasa, masih mirip apa enggak. Kedua, tata bahasanya tetap harus benar. Ketiga, jangan sampai salah arti. Ya. Oke, kita lihat yang punya Rifki dulu.
Sebentar.
Oke, pertama tadi masih berasa mirip nggak? Atau semuanya langsung ya? Ada yang masih terasa mirip? Kelihatannya sudah cukup ini ya, beda ya. Kalian enggak merasakan sesuatu yang sangat sama gitu kan? Ya. Betul? Atau ada yang masih merasa ada kemiripan? Gimana?
Menurut saya sudah cukup berbeda sih.
Ya, beda semua ya. Kedua, kalimatnya tata bahasanya ada yang nggak pas nggak? Tata bahasa Indonesianya.
Bu, saya boleh tanya, Bu?
Iya.
Itu kan ada kata interaksi interpersonal kan ya. Kalau di Indonesia kan mungkin lebih tepatnya itu interaksi per orang gitu ya Bu, antara satu orang dan satu orang lainnya. Nah itu kalau saya menulisnya antar orang gitu bisa nggak Bu? Atau itu terlalu tidak sopan?
Enggak, kalau dibaca dan didengarkan. Maksudnya itu terasa bahasa Indonesia yang normal apa enggak?
Kayaknya kurang sopan sih Bu. Kalau antar orang gitu.
Kadang-kadang, menurut saya sih, kadang-kadang nggak usah diganti juga nggak apa. Kalau nggak ketemu.
Oke, oke. Terima kasih.
Misalnya kayak antar pribadi tadi, saya merasa anu ya, bukan jargon yang umum ya, yang jadinya malah nggak lancar gitu bacanya. Nah, ini yang punya Rifki ini gimana? Sebuah alat yang berguna, salah satunya, kan katanya cuma sebuah, kok bisa ada salah satu ya? Jadi banyak dong. Nah, jadi ini nggak cocok ya kalau secara bahasa Indonesia. Sebuah, kalau sebuah ya pasti cuma ada satu. Kenapa kok ada salah satu? Salah satu dari sebuah itu kan nggak ada ya. Salah satunya bisa hilang. Terus kemudian, ini biasanya kalau saya komentar, bisa itu kalimat yang tidak terasa ini ya, formal ya. Di bisanya diganti apa?
Dapat.
Dapat. Kalau yang kalimat kedua, Vianda ini gimana? Ini ya yang saya lingkari ini. Ini kira-kira masalahnya gimana ya? Selain berguna pendorong itu nggak enak ya. Kalau kalian betulkan jadi apa misalnya?
Mungkin ditambahi sebagai, jadi selain berguna sebagai ya. Pendorong.
Selain berguna sebagai pendorong atau selain berguna untuk mendorong ya, jadi bisa terasa kalau dibaca beberapa kali gitu ya.
Ya,
game juga dapat meningkatkan motivasi dan interaksi interpersonal. Yang punya jergi. Oke ya, tata bahasanya. Saya ngambil pendekatan yang berbeda, diawali dari kata board game. Jadi tadinya board game di tengah-tengah, saya pindah di depan. Nah ini tujuan saya untuk mengganti strukturnya, jadi mengobrak-abrik strukturnya. Walaupun tentang motivasi dan interaksi, jadi ada di belakang. Sama seperti yang aslinya ya. Cuma antar interpersonal saya ubah karena kita lagi ngomongin board game, jadi ya interaksinya jadi antar pemain. Nah, terakhir, jadi tadi bisa dicatat ya kalau mau. Satu, jangan terlalu mirip. Kalian kalau membaca bisa terasa ini mirip enggak? Kedua, tata bahasanya tetap harus enak ya. Ketiga, artinya ada yang melenceng enggak dari semula, dari aslinya.
Kalau menurut saya punyanya Jorgi itu agak melenceng sedikit sih, Bu.
Yang bagian mana?
Karena itu di originalnya itu yang diutamakan, yang highlight utamanya adalah board game itu digunakan untuk mendorong pembelajaran gitu. Jadi dan Jorginya itu jadi kayak di belakang gitu. Itu menurut saya sih.
Untuk yang Rifki, jadi kalau dari aslinya, ya, dari aslinya board game itu berguna untuk pendorong pembelajaran, gitu kan? Selain itu bisa meningkatkan minat dan interaksi. Dari Rifki, berguna sebagai media belajar. Oke, nggak apa. Memotivasi, meningkatkan interaksi, itu tambahannya. Dari Vianda, Vianda ini yang paling, kalau dibanding semua, kalau menurut saya punya Vianda ini yang paling masih agak terlalu mirip, tapi sudah terasa berbeda sih. Cuma kalau dicari yang paling mirip, memang Vianda ya. Pendorong pembelajaran, motivasi, interaksi. Oke. Nah, yang punya Jorgi ini, kalau saya komentar, bukannya memindah pendorongnya yang di depan menjadi di belakang, tapi agak merubah arti menurut saya. Karena kalau saya baca punyanya Jorgi itu, saya merasa board game itu pendorong apa? Pendorong motivasi, pendorong interaksi, dan pendorong pembelajaran. Ya. Kan dalam rangka menambah motivasi dan interaksi serta membantu pembelajaran, board game merupakan alat pendorong yang cocok. Berarti cocok untuk siapa? Untuk tiga ini kan? A dan B serta C gitu kan? Nah, jadi ini mungkin jadi sedikit merubah arti. Padahal yang di sini pendorongnya pendorong belajar. Jadi di sini A, B, C-nya adalah pendorong belajar, meningkatkan minat, tiga interaksi. Oke, itu jadi ini tadi contoh bagaimana kita bisa main-main paraphrase gitu ya. Tidak ada cara lain dalam paraphrase ini selain kalian harus banyak berinteraksi dengan bahasa Indonesia yang oke. Jadi caranya adalah ya mungkin media ya. Media itu banyak yang nggak oke. Jadi media online ini terus terang menurut saya kacau semua. Mungkin satu-satunya media yang menurut saya tata bahasanya masih saya temukan oke itu Suara Surabaya. Terus terang media online ini saya udah ini ya, merasa salah semua tata bahasanya. Saya juga sempat kapan hari dengan dosen-dosen diskusi gitu ya, waktu ngomong mereka ini ya lagi menunjukkan screenshot bimbingan tugas akhir atau proposal atau gimana gitu. Terus kemudian komentar nih tata bahasa seperti apa. Saya berikan screenshot beberapa media online. Saya ngomong, yang di luar sana juga ini sudah bekerja loh. Bukan mahasiswa lagi loh. Kerjanya di bidang berita ini gimana ya? Saya nggak tahu sih. Kok bisa orang-orang seperti ini bisa bekerja di bidang berita? Saya nggak ngerti itu kantor beritanya. Tapi terus terang kacau semua sih. Mulai detik apa ya? Yang biasanya dibaca orang tuh. Yang paling saya oke sih detik CNN Indonesia. Tribun mungkin ya. Saya lupa kalau yang Kompas sama Liputan 6 seperti apa. Tapi yang tiga itu kacau. Jadi kalau mau nyontoh jangan yang situ. Mungkin nggak usah dibaca aja yang itu biar nggak kacau gitu ya library kita. lama-lama kacau loh kalau melihat sesuatu yang salah tapi diulang-ulang terasa benar lama-lama. Nah, jadi nggak ada cara lain selain kita memperbaharui library kita di otak maksudnya dengan kalimat bahasa Indonesia yang baik. Karena mayoritas yang bikin mondar-mandir dan sering salah itu tata bahasa, walaupun sebenarnya itu bukan yang paling krusial, tapi pasti harus diganti tata bahasa yang enggak karuan. Kalau kalian mengenal orang-orang di sekitar kalian dengan tata bahasa yang baik, ya cobalah minta mereka jadi reviewer kalau kalian membuat hal-hal seperti ini ya. Supaya enggak membuang waktu berkali-kali. Harus konsul, terus ganti, konsul, ganti. Oke, jadi ingat tadi tiga hal ya. Satu, jangan mirip. Dua, pakai tata bahasa yang baik. Tiga, artinya jangan berbeda. Saya kira sampai di sini dulu. Kita lanjutkan minggu depan. Jangan lupa mengisi progres. Oke. Terima kasih semuanya.
Saya mau bertanya, Bu, untuk ya. Progres. Ini kan saya disuruh milih dosping kedua. Mm-hmm. Untuk milih itu saya langsung masukkan ke progres dosping keduanya siapa atau lebih baik saya hubungi dulu dosennya?
Nggak usah. Dosping kedua, semua reviewer itu kan sudah ditanya bersedia atau tidaknya.
Oh, jadi saya langsung...
Ya kan? Kalau dia sudah ngomong ya berarti sedia dong.
Oke, Bu. Jadi saya langsung tulis di progres saja ya.
Sudah di ACC berarti?
Sudah, tinggal milih aja ini.
Oke.
Okay. Oke, okay. Terima kasih, Bu.
Oke. Okay. Thank you. Oke, okay, saya end meeting dulu ya sampai ketemu minggu depan.
Terima kasih, Bu.
Terima kasih.